Shahriar, how happy are you with that performance?
It was a very professional performance, you know. When the first innings was over, personally what I felt that Bangladesh has got that. And it was a clinical performance. Bangladeshi bowlers came into the party. They complimented their batting teammates very well today, and very precise, very professional. I like the result. A lot of guys must feel or might feel that it was a easy match for Bangladesh. It wasn't needed to be that easy, but Bangladesh, the way they have played today, that was outstanding.
Yes, of course, all the headlines belonging to Shakib Al Hasan, 51 with the bat. And then, of course, coming to the 5 wickets to his name. The last time someone scored a 50 and then got 5 wickets in a World Cup match, it was way back in 2011. That man was also the most valuable player of that World Cup. And his name is Yuvraj Singh, starting with the bat and ball for India. And look at what India did in that World Cup. Now, the record breaker, Shakib Al Hasan, first Bangladesh player to score 1,000 runs in a World Cup, first Bangladesh player to take a 5-wicket haul in a World Cup, second player to score a 50 and take 5 wickets in a World Cup match. And that's not all. There is more. Believe you me, there's more. Only the third player to score a century and take a 5-wicket haul in a World Cup, first player to score 400 runs and take 10 wickets in a World Cup, only the second player to score 1,000-plus runs and pick 25-plus wickets in a World Cup. Shush. Those are massive numbers. I mean, it's pretty evident that this is possibly the best player Bangladesh cricket has ever seen. But if you put him there amongst the best all-rounders, I'm not saying is he the best, but does he deserve to be in that group now?
I think he's in the conversation with his contemporaries, without doubt. Those numbers are incredible. And once again, even just think about this tournament. He's probably been the player of the tournament so far.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone can really dispute that. A couple of hundreds to his name. At least 150, a 5-wicket haul. He's been instrumental in pulling Bangladesh up into that fifth position where they're really challenging for the four. But over the course of his career, he's probably been underrated, I reckon, with his performances over the years. And I think at the end, when he finishes his career, he's going to go down as one of the greats, and certainly, probably, arguably, the greatest Bangladesh player they've ever had.
You reckon same thing for you?
Completely. You can't dispute.
Has this World Cup brought him into that group, or was he always there?
No, he's always been there. You look at every time you look at the list of ICC all-rounders, he's either one or two.
Yeah.
And that's been the case for a very long time. Look, do you compare him to some of the all-rounders of the past? I don't think it's the right thing to do. But he definitely is a fabulous player. And again, as Huss said, once his career finishes, he will go down as one of the best players to come out of Bangladesh, and he's done everything right. He's not put a foot wrong, except for that miss at the boundary. I don't think he's put a foot wrong in this World Cup.
Just so fabulous with the ball. 5 wickets is not an easy feat, irrespective of what your skill level is or the opponent is. 5 wickets with the ball, he's decimated the opponent there pretty much.
Oh, I thought he showed his skill today, the way he changed his pace. I'm sure Kartik can talk about it a little bit more, the subtleties of it all, but I thought Afghanistan started well with the bat, and then the spinners came on, and particularly Shakib came on and just turned the game. They looked really hard to score off. He was picking up wickets regularly along the way, and it was a great performance with the ball. I don't know, you could probably say a bit more.
Yeah, completely. That's what he does. That's what he relies on. He's not a big spinner of the ball. But what they make up for is with that change of angle, the change of pace, and then getting the arm ball in at the right areas and to the right batsman. That's what he's always been good at. And also preempting what the batsman's going to do. Hmm. Just the wicket when he got, the left-hander stumped. He could see it
yes.
coming.
Yep.
He could see it coming that he was going to run at him. Even before he ran at him, he threw the ball wide and just back of a length so that he goes for it. So these are the kind of things which he's very, very good at.